Just a few weeks after Santa Fe, we'll have our fly-in to Carbondale, Illinois on October 5th and 6th. And just like at Santa Fe, we'll have flyouts to destinations in the area. One flyout is to tour Scott Air Force Base near St. Louis. AOPA Live's Josh Cochran has a story about Scott and one of the important missions there.
For over 100 years, Scott Air Force Base has been home to a variety of missions that are essential to our nation's military.
The reason the base was built was because we needed to train pilots for World War I. So this was a World War I training base. We had standard J-1 aircraft originally, then we went to JN-4 Curtis Jennies.
The aircraft at Scott have gotten a lot more advanced since the days of the Jennies. Now, one of the main missions at Scott is airlift using the C-21, the military version of the Lear 35.
We do DV transport as our primary mission here at Scott Air Force Base. And essentially with the DV transport, we take the 3- and 4-star generals of the Army, Air Force, and sometimes even Navy to and from their different meetings that they may have that affect major MATCHCOM level decisions.
The C-21 has been around since the mid-80s, but for these pilots, older means more fun to fly.
I like to think it's kind of like a 1980s Fox Body Mustang. Okay, there's not a lot of technology. It's lightweight, it's really fast, no cruise control. It's a fun, sporty plane to fly, and I'm sure there's some people out there that would swear it's probably the best plane in the whole fleet.
For the pilots flying the C-21, the missions aren't just fun, they're also rewarding.
Honestly, in my opinion, this is probably the best job in the Air Force. We have a really good squadron of people, and then with the mission that we do, you kind of get to see your small impact of how you add to the mission.
And the C-21 doesn't just transport high-level military officials, it's also used for aeromedical evacuations.
The aeromedical evacuation missions are extremely rewarding to be able to work with the flight nurses and have more of the sense of a crew concept, as well as helping someone that's been injured to get back to their home and their families.
For the men and women who serve at Scott, the relationships with fellow service members is the best part of the mission.
We all have the same common goal to represent the Air Force, and it pushes you to be the best person you can be in a community that I would believe is second to none.
Visitors to Scott during the fly-in will get a chance to see that camaraderie and the airplanes in action. Josh Cochran, AOPA Live.
If you plan to come on the tour of Scott, make sure you sign up on our fly-in websites.